Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. With the year coming to a close now, we don't have much, but there's a bit of standard SpaceX related stuff to take a look at. As well as that, there are just a few bits and pieces in Boca Chica and with Starship to check out. Let's head straight in and get up to date. To kick off this video, yesterday was the 5-year anniversary since SpaceX landed an orbital class rocket booster for the first time. Orbcomm 2 launched on December 22, 2015 with their Falcon 9, then returning to the landing pad to perform the first land landing. SpaceX tweeted a YouTube video recap of the historic mission. Something interesting I thought I would share is this video from NASA, and here you can see an airlock. This was brought up to the ISS by the CRS-21 Dragon capsule earlier in the month and was removed from the Dragon's trunk by Canada Arm 2 recently. Moving on to the Boca Chica news, Michael Baylor has posted some info from the FAA about SpaceX's plans for the Boca Chica site. It apparently says SpaceX is proposing to construct a redundant launch pad and commodities, a redundant landing pad, two integration towers, tank structural test stands, and a desalination plant. We don't have a huge amount of updates, but work has been going on in the launch area. Here you can see them preparing for the arrival of the giant crane known as Tankzilla. At some point, Tankzilla was moved out of the production area down the road to the launch area. As always, the construction all around the orbital launch pad area has been continuing. Inside the production area, some COPVs, or composite overwrapped pressure vessels, were seen being delivered and unloaded. Mary recently did another drive-by of the SpaceX facility, and here is a view of the old gas well lot which SpaceX owns in Boca Chica. It's unclear what they are doing here, but will be interesting to see. Something I haven't shown for a while is the newly constructed building at the restaurant and eating area. It's pretty much complete now. By now, you'll all know of SN8's historic flight and incredible demise. The nose cone is still hanging out on the landing pad. Musk mentioned previously about keeping it as a monument. Looking at her successor, the Starship SN9 prototype was worked on, and they've now attached a new canard after the incident. As we just saw now, Tankzilla has since been detached from the top of SN9 and now moved over to the launch area. Here's a view of SN9 once again standing tall inside the high bay without the assistance of the wall or the crane. Then yesterday, this Starship prototype was rolled out of the high bay and into the yard to be moved to the pad. The Starship SN9 prototype was then rolled down the road over to the launch site for some upcoming testing. She was placed next to the suborbital launch mount on pad B and hooked up to the giant crane to be lifted. Of course, next it was lifted and placed onto the pad B mount, possibly for some pressure testing in the coming week. Engineers then worked to secure the base of the vehicle to the pad so there's no flying during a static fire. Taking a quick look at the road and beach closures, the dates are unchanged at the moment, and with SN9 now at the pad, we can hopefully expect testing pretty soon. Even though there's a closure for today, it's incredibly unlikely that we'll see any testing. However, as soon as Monday, we could potentially see something happen. Super exciting. We also have SN10 with the nose cone stacked to the barrel section last video. It's still currently lacking a fin, as it was probably donated to SN9. Whilst I can't show it, yesterday SN10's tank section was moved into the high bay to take the place of SN9. We also saw the common dome for the first super heavy booster prototype sleeved last episode. It's still currently sitting on the sleeving mount. With all the sections spotted so far, as well as what has been caught already stacked in the high bay, here's the latest diagram from Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to thank the amazing Mary, or Boca Chica girl, who goes out all day every day to film this stuff. Also, thanks to the amazing NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes to provide great space coverage. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.